Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to describe and demonstrate about the level measurement system. In this, we are using different type of level measurement system, and water is a medium to measure the level of a water in different systems, in which we are using DAQ and HMI for one purpose, which are right now nowadays a very industrial useful purpose, and also we will consider a PID controller to measurement of level of water through this system. So this is the complete setup of level measurement system. In this, we are using some different modules for different measurement system. I will explain all the modules one by one. Moving on, there is a complete setup is installed on a study frame with this table having a wheels. In this, there are four wheels. You can easily move the table and complete system aside as your suitability, and as in the lab and the industrial also, in the colleges instrument corridor also. So there are the different measurement sensors. There are five types of different measurement sensors of level. I will also explain the all sensors one by one. And the complete system with the motor and some tank and the measurement tank is the included in this system. So we are also offering a user manual in which all the details about the different modules and different complete system is provided. Also the details about the sensors and the working of the sensor you can study in this user manual. We are also offering a complete box of the accessories in which the HMI interface cable and different batch codes for connections are provided in this suitable box or the pouch, is in which you can easily assemble and place the all accessories in one place. So we are now describing the all modules in this complete setup of level measurement process control. In this is the first one single phase power supply panel in which the 230 volt AC input power socket is provided, by which you can connect the AC power source of 220 volt AC. In this, there is a MCB of 4 amperes provided with a 2 pole MCB of 230 volt for line and neutral, and a bi-directional functional meter is also provided, by which you can take the voltage, amperes, frequency and power factor kVA, kilowatt, kWh also. All the parameters of single phase power supply can be measured with this multifunction meter. Also a power lamp for the pilot lamp for the power indications. There is the two terminal of 230 AC volt supply, by which you can distribute the 230 volt AC supply on different panels. Moving on, this is the digital control panel. In this is the basic system of controlling the measurement system, in which we are using the level current meter. In this is the single display 4-digit 7 segment LED type of display. Types of inputs are 4 to 20 milliamps, which is a current input, and the resolution are different. We can select any of the resolution as per your requirement, and accuracy signal input is ±5%, and supply voltage of this meter is 230 volt supply that we have provided from the power supply panel. Also we are using the PID controller. In this PID controller, we have a dual display of 4-digit 7 segment LEDs, and types of inputs are 420 milliamps. LED status indicator and auto tune output 1 and output 2 in degree centigrade and Fahrenheit are provided on the front panel of this PID controller. Output is a digital control 1 and 2 for pump and wall control are provided, and in the input you have to provide the 4 to 20 milliamps current supply. So supply also for 24 volt supply is provided and distributed for different controlling of outputs of digital output, and the supply of 230 volt AC is also distributed for other panels. Moving on, we have a DAQ panel module, in which this is the digital acquisition and control panel, in which we have used the different DAQ module, in which we have to provide the different digital inputs. It has 8 digital inputs and 4 digital outputs. Also 4 analog inputs and 2 analog outputs are provided. PC and HMI interface communication cables are also provided. This is the 24 volt power supply distribution, by which we can use the 24 volt power supply at any substance on this panel. This is the AC supply input for this DAQ panel module. Moving on to the HMI panel. This is the HMI panel module. In this HMI panel module, we have a 7-inch 800x480 pixels HMI with a TFT LCD display of 65,000 colors, and user memory of this HMI is 128 MB flash and 64 MB DRAM. Data logging of inbuilt up to 1 lakh logs are provided with this HMI, and display configuration is a 7-inch resistive touch screen with IP65 protection. Communication is of RS-485 which supports, and also RS-232, RS-485 on COM2 as well. USB port, we have also provided a USB port of 2.0 on the right side of this HMI panel, at which you can control and use any pen drive to get the data logs of the complete system. This works on the 24 volt power supply that we have provided from the DAQ panel as well, and the DAQ HMI interface also connected with the DAQ panel. Moving on to the input output panel, this is the 230 volt AC 50 hertz and 24 volt DC supply, input supply are both provided on this panel. We have a start stop pump and wall switch inputs for the different inputs module. These are the different push buttons, and also indicator outputs for process status, pump and wall, as well as alarm for all the different terminals. And contactor are inside connected and installed for pump, and the solenoid valve provided on this complete panel. Moving on, we have a sensor panel in which we have connected all the panel or the sensors at different lines up, and all the sensors are described with the connectors provided on this. We have supply of this panel is the 230 volt AC and plus 24 volt DC supply input, and the ground terminals are internally connected with this. You can connect the all red terminal for taking the current output from all the sensors, which describes the level. And there are different type of 5 sensors. I will explain all the sensors one by one. We have a complete setup of water flow arrangement in which we have installed and completely built up the PVC type and the different T and the other components for the water flow management, in which we use the different valves. This is the sump tank in which we have to fill the water, which have to be leveled is to measurement. By this setup or by this line, you can input going through the from the measurement tank, and the motor can suck the water from below of the tank, and this is the drain wall provided here, which is the V5, and by drain wall closed you can suck the water from this motor, and this motor will put the water from this line to the tank, and this is the overflow wall, overflow line of the tank, at which you can easily overflow the water if in case you fill the water from the exceed limit. And there are different sensors, so now we will move on to the sensor descriptions. So we have installed the 5 different types of sensors to taking the level of water. So we will start with the capacitive level transmitter. In this, the probe is installed inside the tank and connected with this complete module. This is the capacitive level transmitter. The output of current of 4 to 20 milliampere will be provided on the sensor panel as I described on the modules, and the output of the level as the water touches the probe of the sensor, capacitive sensor, the capacitance between the conducting element water and the probe generates, and the value of the capacitance changes as per the water level changes. So this will observe and transmitted in the current form, and this will observe the at the sensor panel by DAQ and the other PID controller modules. So we will also observe how the sensor works. Moving on to the ultrasonic level transmitter. In this transmitter, the ultrasonic waves are impacted on the water level. So we have provided a hole here on the front tank, on the upside of the tank, by which the ultrasonic waves has been impacted on the water level, and as the surface increase or decrease, the level of the ultrasonic wave reflections will be also decreased. This, hence the level changes and the waveform and the wavelength changes of the ultrasonic wave, This will converted in the electrical form, and the electrical form can be read from our panels. Now moving on, this is the point to point sensor. In this we will use the two points of low and high. This just gives the single signal of low and the high input at the lower end, in which also a rod connected and a float with the rod. So as the water level increases, the float will flow with the lower level to the upper level. As the float remains to the lower level, this will give the low input, and as the float with the water increase and the level of the float increase and it reaches to the high point, this will give the high point. And similarly, there is a magnetic sensor. In this magnetic sensor we have provided the 24 volt power supply, and this power supply is converted in the current signal. Float is also provided with this sensor also, and as the float position changes, the current value of the generated transmitted output also changes. So this output of the current output from the magnetic sensor is also measured by the DIQ panel and the PID control panel provided on the module. And this is the last sensor that we have used here. This is the pressure level transmitter. In this, as the this is connected directly bottom of the tank, and as the line filled with this water and the water level increase, the pressure from the water to the this pressure sensor will increase, and this will transmit different values as per the water level inside the measurement tank. And this value can be read from the DIQ and PID panel, and this is also electrical value, electrical current value, which can be read by different modules provided on the DIQ and modules panel. Now we are moving on to the experiment section with this level process control system. In this, there are the some fixed connection which are provided and already connected on the front panel, as you seen. So these connections should be remain same for all the practicals we have to do apart from these connections, and these are described in experiment by experiment provided on the experiment section. This is the connection wiring table also provided in this user manual. So these connections should be remain same for all the practicals. Now there are PID controller, so meter settings of the PID controller and complete manual of to do different settings in different parameter groups are provided. You can study all the parameters to do different settings of the PID controller as well. And these are the different input type range of the PID controller are given. You can use thermocouple, RTD, analog. So we are using with the current value here, so we will only set the value on the 0.4 to 20 milliamps, which is AIA2 provided on the front panel. So in the percentage range we will calibrate the PID controller as described. Moving on, these are the settings of the current level meter provided on. So these settings for different resolution, input type, and input scale high, input scale low, display scale high, display scale low can be calibrated as per the requirement. Moving on to the first experiment, which is to study the measurement and control of water level using sensors, level sensors, and DIQ and HMI panel. So on the completion of this experiment, we will understand the working of DIQ and human machine interface HMI and its application for controlling the water process system. This is the connection table provided here, by which you can do all the connections for this experimental setup, and we will follow the procedure as described in the user manual. And these are the connection apart from this. This is the connection diagram also provided on the user manual. For basic connections of DIQ and HMI, we will first use the input output panel for providing different inputs to the DIQ module. So in the connection table this is provided. So we will connect the start input or the T5 terminal with the T11 of the DIQ module, T6 with the T12 of the DIQ module, T7 of T13, and T8 will be connected with T14. So these are the four digital inputs that we have provided to the DIQ module. And now we move on to the outputs. So So the output will be processed from the DAQ and will be indicated on the indicators. So we will connect the T13 and T14, 15, 16. These are the digital outputs from the output section. So T2 and 23, always make sure the output sequence should be properly matched as described in the user manual. So you will not get the other indication from the other output. So these are the all four digital outputs that you have connected from this panel. Now moving on to the sensor connections. We will connect all the sensors to the analog inputs of the DAQ and we will start connecting with magnetic float sensor. So the magnetic float sensor or T11 will be connected with the T17. For first we will connect the point-to-point sensor. So point-to-point sensor will give the digital output or digital input. So we will connect with the digital input of the DAQ module. So we will connect T11 with the T17 and T12 with the T18 terminal. So this is the T12, this will be connected with T18 terminal. So all the digital inputs are connected. Now we will connect the analog outputs of the sensor as an analog input to the DAQ module. So we will connect the T3 from the magnetic sensor. This will be connected with the T19. T5 will be connected with T20. T7 will be connected with T21 and T9 will be connected with T22. So this is the all analog connections that has been done. Our circuitry and circuit connections has now been complete. Now we will follow the procedure. So in this procedure we will on the wall as described in the user manual, so we can observe the level and the water will be flow from zero level to the maximum level that we have set for the measurement section. So now we will first power on the supply with the MCB provided on the power supply panel. So as I power on the supply, in some time HMI will also start and this will showing the pilot lamp is showing that the power is on of the HMI and the complete level process system. So this is the flow process diagram of the complete system. In this we have used different valves. So we required to open and shut for required valves. So in this valve number and the valve description is provided on this table. In this V1 is for return flow control of measuring tank to into some tank and V2 is for manual outlet of the measuring tank and V3 is the pressure sensor inlet and V4 is the outlet of some tank from the drainage and V5 is the inlet of the some tank to fill the water and there is a solenoid valve also connected. This will be operated by the different panel as we use in the experiments and solenoid valve control outlet will be going to the measuring tank out of the measuring tank and going into the some tank. So these are the valve description. All valves are marked in the complete system. So now we will follow the procedure. For this we have connected the three phase or single phase supply to power on the circuit. Connections that we have done already as per the circuit diagram and we have on the power and observe the pilot lamp is green. Now we will follow the procedure for first to measure the water flow level using different level sensor. So in this we will go to the HMI section. The HMI consists different indications for start, stop, pump and valve. This can be operated to the by touching the HMI all the systems and these are the status LED and the status lamps on the HMI that will show the status of that the status is on, buzzer is on, pump is on and the valve is on. And this is the magnetic capacitive pressure, ultrasonic and point to point sensor outputs in the MM. This will be giving the sensor of the level of the water from the sensor outputs and point to point sensor is giving that the low input is right now not reaching as we do not fill the water in the tank right now till the point to point sensor's low level. When it will reach the low level, the low level indication will be green, and when the float will go to the high level will be red. So this will show us that we should off the pump when we get the high level. This is the limit of the measurement tank. And for measurement, we will first do the all experiment on the measure screen, and then we will in the next section we will control the complete system automatically. So for measuring and maintaining the level of the measurement tank, so we will control the system with the control screen. So this is the control screen and this is the measurement screen. By this icon you can reach to all the screen. So now we will first do the measurement. So we'll use this measure screen. So now we will start first the pump and with the start section, with the measurement section of the HMI screen, and this will give the output of all sensors. Where as the level increases in the measurement tank, the output will be shown on the HMI levels. Before that, we have to keep the valve V1 and V3 open, V2, V4 and V5 closed. So right now we have opened the V1 valve. This will the outlet of the measurement tank, and V3, which is the valve for the pressure sensor in the pressure line, this should be open, so the output from the pressure sensor will also be provided. Now we should close the V2 valve, the drainage valve and the inlet valve of the sump tank. So these three valves should be closed and these two valves will be open. Now we will start the procedure. First press the start key here. So this will give the status that the start of the functioning is started. Here in the input output panel, pilot lamp is also glowing, that this is showing that the process is start. Now we will press the pump button and this will start the pump, and water will flow from some tank to the measurement tank. So as I press the pump has been started, and this is start flowing the water from some tank to the measurement tank. At the measurement tank, from the side window you can also observe the level is increasing of the water slowly. So now all the sensors are giving inputs, has given input started from different levels. So all the levels simultaneously equal. Here ultrasonic sensor is not giving continuously proper level. It is because that the water is flowing, so water level is not stable. As the water level will get the stability, the output will be proper from the ultrasonic sensor. So this is the sensor, and right now you can also see the point-to-point sensor has given the low limit of the point-to-point sensor has been reached. This is showing the limit is low. Now for the animated representation, you can also see that the water is flowing from some tank through the motor to the measurement tank, and this is also showing the level in the engineered value process. Now this is giving the level of different levels. Now we will press valve button, and as I press the valve button, pump has been stopped and the solenoid valve is on, and this will drain the measurement tank water through the solenoid valve, and the solenoid valve is on right now, and this is flowing the water from measurement tank to the sump tank. So the water from the measurement tank will be empty in the sump tank again filled up. You can see this process on the animation also. Right now you can see the water from the measurement tank is draining to the sump tank again. So this is how we measure the all levels. Here you can see the water level is decreasing slightly and slowly. So the sensors are giving their level measurements accordingly. So this is the first practical of measurement of the level using HMI and DAQ. Now we will control the level to maintain on the set level. So now we will do the experiment B of the DAQ and HMI panel. So now we going to control the water level using different level sensor, in which we will automatically control the water. So in last experiment we have measured the water level, now we will control the water level from the HMI panel. So now we move on to the HMI panel. Here in this we will select this icon. This will start the controlling of the water, in which we do not require to control any of the water substance. As the system was startup, we can stop the system here by pressing the stop button, and the stop will be indicated by the buzzer. The buzzer will blowing for up to 15 minutes and after that it will automatically off. Here you can see buzzer is right now off. Now for setting of the set points, there are also given in the setting setup by pressing the setting button. In this the set point is 100 mm, so we have to maintain the water up to 100 mm in the measurement tank, and the hysteresis that we have given is the 2 mm. So as the water reaches 100 plus 2, about 102 mm, this will stop the pump, and as the water will go through the and stop the pump and on the wall, so the wall will drain the water from the measurement tank, so the level will go down, and the level as the level reach up to 100 minus 2 up to 98, this will again start the pump, and the process will continuously happen so that the water level will be maintained. In the other settings, the magnetic sensor and capacitive sensor range, minimum range and the milliampere range are given. These are the factory setting, you should not be changed or any of the value from these. So moving on, we will now going to the control section, and as I press the start, it will start the pump as well and flow the and the level from the different sensors provided on the screen, from magnetic, capacitive, pressure and ultrasonic sensor. So our set point is 100 provided on the HMI screen. As we reach the 100 point, the motor has been stopped and this will on the wall, and again as I increase the level decrease, this will turn on the motor again. Here you can see as the level from the measurement tank decreases, this will turn on the motor again. Here as you can see, as the water level reaches 100 mm through the magnetic sensor, so magnetic sensor is the primary sensor right now at which we are working, and as the level decreases, it will automatically start from the lower level and pump will start again. So this is how we controlling the water level at a same level with the stresses of 2. Here you can see pump is again started to maintain the water level. Also you can study and see the line of the magnetic sensor. This is the yellow line provided on the graphical display. So this is giving the lower and higher graph of the yellow line. In this the abbreviation are provided for pressure, ultrasonic, capacitive and different sensors. Of the color line is provided. So this is the basic display of and graphical representation of control system of level measurement. You can also log the complete data from the different data logs. So by pressing this log data, you can observe the data logging from per second of all the sensor are provided in this data log module. So up to 1 lakh data logs you can tag the data file. So by pressing this USB icon, you have to insert the USB in the side panel or the right side of the panel. There is a USB slot at which you can connect the USB at that. So you have to enter the right date or time and by which you can log the data, from which till the time you want to log the data. So the data in the Excel file and the .csv format, you can upload and download the data, complete data logging from this. Now we're moving to the control panel again to see the working of the controlling. Here you can see 99 is the complete section and wall is on right now, and wall is decreasing the level of the measurement tank, and as the measurement tank level will decrease, the wall will off and the pump will start. So this is how the controlling works in the level measurement system with the DAQ module and HMI panel. Negative, we will connect T4 with the T6. Here after some time you will observe that the level of the water in percentage value is shown on the PID controller. This is the 27.8. You can change the set value, which is described in the green indications, green LED digits. So I will increase the set value to the 30% from this PID controller and press mode. So our set value has been changed to 30%. Now water level is 27.8%, and we will connect the digital output from both the outputs for controlling the pump and wall. So from the digital control output 1, we have connected the pump, and from the digital output 2 or the T10 terminal, we will connect the wall. So this is the PID controller setup. All the settings of PID controller has been done inside. As you can see, the level from in the percentage value is above from the set value, which is the 30.0. Right now level is 30.5. So this will on the wall frequently in potential integral differentiate, and slowly one by one, here you can see wall is on for some time, and after that in the third cycle this will on some more time, and in the fourth cycle this will on for some time till the level will be decreased. So I will decrease the level manually by opening the wall here. So you will observe that the pump will also working. Now I am manually decreasing the level by opening the extra drain wall of the measurement tank. Here you can see level goes down. I have quickly turned off the wall and motor has been started. So pump fill the water again in the level. So pump after reaching the level has been stopped. So magnetic sensor's output is read by the PID controller, and PID controller controlled output is controlling the pump and wall. So that's how we control the water level using the magnetic level sensor, a solenoid valve and a pump with the PID controller setup. So we have already done the setting for measuring the current in this PID controller. Now for measurement of the level, just showing the current meter. In the current meter, so the level will be shown. So we will connect both the wire from upper two terminals to the current meter. Here you can see level of the measurement tank is 30.4. here in this PID controller setting, the setting is also described in the user manual. You can see and do the settings. Now I will explain you the calculations for the scaling provided in the user manual. Here the output of the magnetic float sensor is 4 milliamperes to 14.0 milliamperes at the maximum value. So the minimum value we have 4.11 milliampere, maximum value we have 14.05 milliampere. So we have a span of 14.04 minus 4.11, which is the 9.94 unit we have span. So the PID controller water level range is 0 to 100% for 4 to 20 milliampere. So minimum value will be showing 0, maximum value is 100, so we have a span of 100. So we will calculate both the span for step size in PID. So the span of PID controller is span of magnetic float transmitter divided by 100 divided by 16. So we have 6.25 milliampere percent for 1 milliampere. So we, as we provide the 1 milliampere to the PID controller, this will showing that the 6.25% has been increased or decreased. Therefore, PID controller water level for 4.11 minus 14.2 will be minimum PID range, and maximum PID range can be multiplied by the 6.25 factor that we have get, which is equals to 1, and maximum range will be equals to 63 approx. So the span is 63 minus 1 will be 62. So step size of PID controller is similarly 6.2% of the PID input. So from DAQ and HMI panel, we have calculated the HMI display range, which is the minimum value 0 and maximum value 210 for the mm, and the span we get 210, and step size we by calculating at the upper process. Similarly, we will get the HMI for 1 milliampere input is equals to 21.12 mm. Therefore, span of HMI display reading is equals to span of PID controller reading. So therefore, ratio will be 210 divided by 62. So this is 3.39 approx. Hence, the actual water level reading in the mm is equals to PID controller reading in percentage and minus PID reading for the minimum input of current into 3.39. So that you will get the reading accordingly. So in this, there is a simple calculation explained for the 35% setting in the PID controller. So we will get the level is equals to 9.55 milliampere current, and level is 115.26 mm. So these are the complete calculations that can be easily understood, described in the user manual also. And for the other sensor arrangement and for other practicals, you just have to change the sensor connection in the observation table for said level water level of 25% at any of the percentage you want to do the experiment. You can check the actual water level on the screen or the PID controller and time, and you can conclude the graph for different time settings. This you will get the very stable graph as described in the HMI also. The manual graph will be the same. So thus we have concluded and studied the measurement of water level sensor using magnetic float sensor. For working with the capacitive sensor, same connections has to be provided. Just we have to use the capacitive sensor on the place of magnetic sensor, and all the walls and circuitry will be the same. And for the span calculation and the circuitry calculation will be same. And working with the pressure sensor, make sure the wall V3 of the pressure line sensor should be on. So the pressure should be applied on the pressure sensor. So sensor and the calculations will be same. Just we have to change these connections from magnetic sensor to capacitive sensor. For other measurement, we will use the pressure sensor and also ultrasonic sensor. Point-to-point sensor just give the digital outputs, so we do not use for the controlling them. And this is how we use the PID controller with different sensor. You can just have to change the connection of the sensor connections to take the whichever sensors you want to study. So this is all about this level process control system. So this was the basic explanation, first with the HMI and DAQ module of the level measurement, and also in the second experiment with the magnetic sensor, we have controlled the PID controller using the PID controller. We have controlled the measurement level of the measurement tank. You can also use all the sensor one by one on the PID controller to controlling the measurement and study how the sensor will work for the level measurement. All the details about the sensor and detailed study you can do from the user manual that we are providing with this kit. And with this sensor kit, you can do all the experiment easily. If you find any difficulties doing the experiments or studying and working of the sensors, you can study the user manual properly, you refer the user manual, or you can contact Tuteska Technologies Private Limited for all the supports. Thank you.